Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be showing you how I did this beautiful home decor from Dollar Tree. So first I went to canva.com and picked out a print that I wanted and I printed it out to size. Now you can do this on Canva or you can do this on Microsoft Word. Now this is if you want to make your own stencil. This is what I'm doing right now, is making a stencil. But if you want to just go and buy the letters from Walmart or a craft store, then you are more than welcome to do that. This is just free. So I am using an X-Acto knife, but if you don't have one, you can use scissors. Just be extremely careful. This is just me going in and just taking off the black part so that the white part will be left over, and that's what I'm going to be using
to trace with.
Don't you just love fast forward videos? Isn't this so satisfying, guys? Look it. Look how satisfying this is. It just makes me want to sing that song. Get no satisfaction. Satisfaction. Sorry guys, I'm weird. So these were the silver plates that I bought from Dollar Tree, and I'm just going in with a chalk paint and painting those. It did take a couple of coats. I would do around 3 coats just to make sure everything is nice and covered. And the chalk paint I did get from Walmart, I spent around $6, but it's well worth it because the chalk paint will last me well over 7 projects. So I have already taped this paper to the plate. And right here I'm just going in and tracing with a pencil, so that I know where to paint. And I'm just going in here now and painting inside of that outline that I just did with pencil. So I actually saved that stencil that I did because I'm doing 2 home plates like this. So you're going to take a piece of burlap ribbon and cut it to your liking. And you're gonna glue the ends together. And then you're going to take a smaller piece and you're going to place it right on top of the larger piece. Make sure you like how that looks. And then you're going to take another piece of burlap ribbon and place it on top of those 2. It's going to be like the legs that go over. So you're going to take your twine. I got mine from Dollar Tree, of course. And you're going to just take a little piece of that and wrap it around the middle of the bow. And that's going to secure the middle of the bow. So just flip it around, pinch the inside of the bow a little bit, and just tie a couple of knots there on the back so that the middle is secure. So right here I'm just fluffing out the bow to make it look nice, and I am putting a V-slit on both of the little flaps coming down to make it more look like a bow. It doesn't have to be perfect, obviously, so just go in and just make those 2 V's, and then I am cutting off the excess strings to make it look nicer as well. Okay, so right here I'm just hot gluing this rope that I got from Dollar Tree as well onto the plate. And just a side note, guys, the rope is 4 feet long at Dollar Tree, so it covered all of the plates that I had to cover with the rope width. And this one I'm going to be putting the greenery on in the bow. The greenery I got from Walmart for $1, so it's still $1. And I just love how that turned out, isn't it pretty? Not sure if I want this. You don't think that I want this. This is a lot of human use, but I don't want to play the quiet time when I'm near you. Pretending that I don't know who you are every time I just a side note, the black paint that I'm using I got from Dollar Tree as well. I did show that in my last DIY haul from Dollar Tree. So in order to hang these, I went ahead and just took like a string and glued it to the back and made sure that they were even. And here is the finished product. If you're new here, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and the bell so you'll know when I get new videos uploaded. Thanks guys! Hope y'all enjoyed it.